To fight at a true witcher's side. Prime the way you swung that razor, mate.
Mention some fee from a guild. I hear you right.
Ha! Witcher drives right for the gut. A professional, right thorough. Your share, friend. Every last copper as we agreed. We'll collect us a few of them silver scales and a tail. Proof for the guild, right?
And we'll get word of you to some folk. Merchant folk, meaning. They ought to treat you right.
Thanks, and farewell.
My cost. My poor, your cost.
Basilisk beat. Quick and thorough. That augurs well.
Your cust. My poor, your cust. Cruelly slaughtered, like a common beast.
We've got a damn good reason to celebrate.
My poor, your cust. Cruelly slaughtered, like a common beast.
Ooh. Ooh.
Come on, Roach.
Knight, I'd ventured north in search of herbs for a new flavored wine. When suddenly...
Calm down. It's over.
The Bang Diddlers kidnapped me. In hopes of collecting a ransom, I'm sure. But with Master Liam's troubles, he never could have paid them. Ah, but I'm free and safe, thanks to you. Should you need any herbs, I've a hearty stock at the Coronata. Will you walk me there?
Lead the way, right behind you.
Here we are. Once again, I thank you for the rescue. Wish to look over my stock?
Master Liam doesn't seem a diligent proprietor.
He tries as best he can. It's not his fault our vineyard suffered plague upon plague.
Plagues? What kind?
Well, the enormous yellow man-eating sun juice, for instance. You cannot set foot into the brush for fear of coming out a head shorter.
Show me what you got. Thanks. See you later.
Let's go. Whoa there, Roach.
Incinerate them before they spew spores and spread. Archospore saplings? Takes a degenerate to cultivate something like this. Need to incinerate them before they spew spores and spread. Crespi's behind the sabotage at both vineyards. Gotta tell Matilda and Liam.
Master Witcher, have you any news?
This vineyard, Belgard, why is it so valuable?
You are not from here, it certainly shows. Before Count Crespi fell prey to the beast, Belgard belonged to him. As a man of wealth and influence, he guided it to immense success, brought in rare grape varieties, hired skilled workers. I shan't trouble you with unnecessary details. Suffice to say that merging Belgard with another vineyard is a sure recipe for success.
One and the same man caused Coronada's and Vermentino's problems. Got proof. A certain Count Crespi. He's at the root of it all.
What, Crespi? Belgard's erstwhile owner? Why, that's impossible.
Got it all here, in writing.
He did, indeed, have motive. He knew well his own vineyard could not survive if Vermentino and Coronata were to join forces.
Probably why he incited the feud. Pulled it off, too, mostly. Just failed to bring his plan to completion when the beast got him.
Incredible! You mean to say it wasn't Liam?
And I was certain my troubles were Matilda's doing.
In light of new evidence, the most just resolution would be for both injured parties to share oversight of Belgard.
Wait just a minute. Do you mean to suggest we're to cooperate?
It's the optimal solution, yes. In terms of the health of the enterprise as well.
I can't believe I'm saying this, but I do believe he's right. Perhaps it is time to bury the hatchet.
Three vineyards are more than one. There's much to be gained. So be it.
That's not all. The troubles at your vineyards? Solved them. You can go back to operating normally now.
Splendid news. I'm relieved to see you hired a professional, especially one whose aid might still prove invaluable. But let's not get ahead of ourselves. Follow me. It's high time you saw Belgard.
Witcher, come with us, please. Something tells me we'll have tasks for you yet.
All right, let's go.
My desire for Belgard to pass into capable hands was no idle whim, for the vineyard's fallen upon hard times since its previous owner's demise. I've been told of workers dying on their rounds, monsters prowling about. Before anyone can call this home, they will have to deal with these inconveniences. That is the minister's wish.
More work for me, I guess.
If you're willing, we'll gladly accept your help.
I can help, sure, but I won't work for free.
Fine. We have a deal.
More or less already agreed, I guess.
Oh, that's a weight off my chest, I must say. Your reward shall be fair, I promise.
I'll get to work.
Let's go!
Oh! You!
What's up, Kitty Ice?
Oh! Come on.
Oh! Hold that walking.
Faster. Giddy up.
Ah!
Scholars pitched camp here. Should look around.
Thank you, sir. Were it not for you, well, those bandits were not pulling pranks. I could pound some new steel for you in gratitude, but I must first return to my workshop in Belgard.
Drop by when I'm in the area.
Where are you walking?
Tended to Belgard's problems. Vineyard should be in as good a shape as ever.
Splendid. And thus, officially, by the power vested in me, I grant you title to the Belgard Vineyard, and trust that you shall make good use of its grounds and resources.
Excellent. Ah, I can already smell the grapes ripening in the sun.
We shan't forget what you did for us. Here, your pay.
But that's not all. You must come back and see us shortly. We've a surprise in store for you.
I'll do that. Farewell.
You'll frighten me, kiddies.
Looking for you. It will only take a moment, I promise.
Greetings, sourpuss.
Something's in the wind.
Oh, Witcher, greetings. Kind of you to come. Matilda and I, we've a surprise for you.
You two seem to be getting along.
We are. There came a point we realized we had no grounds to quarrel. Things became altogether pleasant.
And a bit spicy.
Romantic, quite.
Got it. Needn't say more. Glad things are going well for you. What's the surprise? Some new monster I need to kill?
No, something far more pleasant.
We've produced a wine. According to the best sommeliers, it might just dethrone Est.
We owe this success to you. So, if you'd agree...
We'd like to name it after you.
What shall we call it?
Maybe Butcher of Blaviken?
A strong name. I like it.
If you wouldn't mind, we'd like to send a few bottles to your home every so often.
I'd be honored. Thanks.
No, we thank you. Take care, Witcher.
Praise to the grapes in whose effluent richness we drown.
Oh!
We are...
And a...
Romance?
Got it. What?
No.
We did...
What shall...
Call it... Geralt de Rivia.
Geralt de Rivia. Perfect.
If you wouldn't mind, we'd like to send a few bottles to your home every so often.
I'd be...
Praise to the grapes in whose effluent richness we drown.
Oh!
And... What's this?
What?
Why not White Wolf?
Wild, with character. It fits perfectly.
If you wouldn't mind, we'd like to send a few bottles to your home every so often.
I'd be honored. Thanks.
No, we thank you. Take care, Witcher.
It's hard and girthy.
Mama says that if someone's really, but I mean really, really, really bad, it means his heart is made of stone.
Night, dear children, is a peculiar cross between a loose woman and a scholar, which is to say, he's a plowing know-it-all.
Aye, the pigs can fly.
Why do you stick around?
Tip of the hat to the thorny sanctuary.
I'm going to save with my hands! Watch your stones!
Your reputation precedes you,
Gary. You seek someone?
My hands shake so bad, I cannot hold my tools.
The palace is secure.
And our dearly departed Milton de...
Geralt of Rivia, Master Witcher.
I was not mistaken. You arrived and trouble followed soon after.
Step aside. Got a matter for the Duchess.
At last, Witcher. We've been on tenterhooks. Did you catch Milton's killer?
Case is more serious than we thought. The beast? I couldn't kill it. Didn't manage.
We sent you after a monster, and you return with nothing? We are very disappointed.
Situation's not quite that simple. Beast's a powerful vampire.
Is this a problem? Is it too much for a witcher? A monster slayer? But everyone knows how to end a vampire. Draw him by trick into sunlight. Or arm yourself with ample garlic and drive a stake through its heart.
Garlic's useless against vampires. Sun and stakes don't hurt him either. Those methods, pure invention, only work in legends and fables.
And buckthorn? When I was a child, Grandmama Admarta always claimed buckthorn drives off vampires.
Silver sword's your best option for keeping them at bay. But it won't get the job done, because only a higher vampire can truly kill another of its kind.
Excuses. Ha! Your Grace, I shall assemble a battue. Bring the matter to its end at once. The Witcher need but tell us where to find this monster.
Go ahead. Send them to their death. Certain death.
To a lone Witcher, perhaps. To 40 of my men-at-arms, but another skirmish.
40, 50, 100? Doesn't matter. Won't make any difference against him.
You have not seen my guardsmen in action.
Can they fight fog? Hit a target that moves faster than the wind?
How? What creature can do such things?
Creatures like this one. Higher vampires, we call them. Each one's a little different. Unique or exceptional, you might say. Some transform into giant bats. Others communicate with animals, command them.
Yet all are still brainless beasts.
Dead wrong. Thinking of lesser vampires. Alps, Ekamaras, Catacans, for instance. They're ruled by instinct, sure. Attack anything that smells of blood. Higher vampires? They think. They employ reason.
Monsters driven by reason. A curious contention. What, then, do you intend to do?
It's way beyond being some monster. This is a powerful being that's walked the world for centuries.
Yeah, impossible. If so great is their power, why have they not killed or enslaved us all?
Don't usually meddle in our matters. Mostly stay out of our way because they don't care about humans one way or the other.
And they do not fear we shall wipe them out one day.
They'd probably be pretty amused if you asked them that. They're well aware of their strength.
Then what can we do? Do you have a plan?
Try to talk to him. That's our best bet.
I cannot believe this. Her Grace summons a Witcher to kill a monster. Instead, he wishes to chat with it.
Know what I'm doing. His lover was kidnapped. He's being blackmailed.
Blackmailed? Be so kind as to explain how a vampire might be blackmailed.
Higher vampires? They're like us, motivated by emotions, not instinct. Not only are they intelligent to an extreme, they're emotionally rich, capable of feeling many things, even love. This one fell in love with a woman, a human, and he'll do anything to keep her from harm.
You do not, I trust, suggest we let Milton's killer go free, or wait until it murders again. We must render it harmless as quickly as possible.
Which is why that's my aim now, to prevent further attacks. Vampire's only half the problem. Blackmailer's at fault chiefly. Kidnapped the woman to control the vampire.
And what do you propose to do?
I'll find the blackmailer, free the vampire's lover.
You were to destroy him, not help him.
No one else should die. That's most important. As soon as the woman's safe, he'll have no more reason to kill.
I admit to being swayed, Witcher. You may be right. Do you know anything about the blackmailer?
Got one lead. A few scraps of paper. Blackmailer wrote the names of the vampire's victims on them. One of them stained. A drop of wine, looks like. So damn little to go on.
You've no idea how wrong you are, my dear. Send for the Ducal Sommelier. Hop, hop! In Tucson, wine is sacred. Here there is no such thing as a drop of wine, or stains therefrom. They are stains from a drop of Estest, Ervelus, Fiorano.
Your Grace wished to see me?
Witcher, show him the paper scrap. Benoit, can you determine which wine made this stain?
The West Bank of the Saint Retour. That's rather obvious. Aged in barrels of Beauclair oak. Hue, deep burgundy. Clarity, high. It's simple. Saint Real. The 1269 vintage.
That's impossible. The wine is produced at Castel Ravello, especially and exclusively for the ducal table. Perhaps some Saint Real was stolen. We must go to the vineyard, see if there's not been an incident.
Saint Real. Never heard of it.
It's highly unlikely you've ever had a chance to partake of it. As I said, it is only ever served to the ducal family.
Didn't stop it from ending up on that scrap of paper. Unless your Grace's sommelier is mistaken.
In matters of wine, Benoit is never mistaken. If he says it's Saint Real, it is Saint Real. We must ride to Castel Ravello at once. Discover what has happened.
Wait. Your Grace wants to go with me? Out of the question.
I hope you do not suppose we will sit on our ducal hiney and do nothing while our duchy is in grave danger.
Your Grace, what you propose is far too dangerous. The Witcher should go alone.
It pleases me to see you gentlemen finally agree on something. But I've made my decision. We shall go. Accompanied by the best possible escorts. You, Captain, and Geralt. We will travel incognito. We've no wish to give the court any reason to gossip. For the duration of this mission, I release you from your obligation to adhere to court protocol. In short, from now on, I am Anna Henrietta, not your Grace.
Yes, your Grace. Witcher, are you ready?
Yeah, ready to go.
Excellent. Give me a moment. I must don something more appropriate and concealing. Then we will be off.
this vampire. Have you ever faced its sort before?
I have.
How did it end? Did you kill it?
Didn't have to fight him. Hadn't killed anyone.
Have you ever heard of anyone defeating such a vampire?
Know of a man who defeated one, sure. But he didn't manage to kill it. Ultimately, only another vampire can kill a vampire.
A job is like a lady.
Panthers have attacked the
wagon!
Come
on now.
We must help!
Stay back, your grace! We shall see to this!
Back, you beast! Be gone!
How do you like that silver?
They were fortunate.
Thank you.
They happened by.
You saved our lives.
Hooray!
Tell me more about this vineyard, Castel Ravello.
It's the best in Ortusa. An old master of the winemaker trade runs it. Fabrizio.
He trustworthy?
He's held his post for years. There's never been a problem. Till now. I wish to know your thoughts, Geralt. The Sonrial stain. How did it wind up on the paper? Is someone from the vineyard blackmailing the vampire?
Could be a servant. Could be the steward. Could be the wine was just stolen from the estate.
We shall know when we arrive. It's not far now.
Slower.
Captain de la Tour, we did not expect any visitors from the palace. How are affairs at court?
Doubtless you've heard of the Beast of Beauclair. Well, we've our hands full. Especially since the rogue last attacked in the palace gardens.
I trust her illustrious highness was not harmed.
Kind of you to ask, Master Fabricio. I am well.
Your grace? We were not warned. I shall order the salon prepared at once.
That won't be necessary. As you can see, we are not here on an official visit.
Naturally. Might I ask then what has brought you to Castel Ravello?
This is an inspection. We've got questions. You'll answer them.
And who are you, sir, to speak to me this way?
This is Geralt of Rivia, a witcher. He has come to Toussaint on my personal invitation.
Which is to say...
Which is to say I expect you to treat him with the utmost respect.
Of course, Your Grace.
Did you hear that, witcher? Fabricio will be delighted to answer your every question.
Want to talk about Saint-Réal?
I am at your service.
The Saint-Réal. How many vineyard workers have access to it?
One might say only I do.
Not like you make the wine all alone. At least a dozen others work here.
I see you've little notion how wine is made. Grapes travel a long road before they become Saint-Réal. The workers assist me only to the stage of fermentation. I see to the maceration personally and let no one near the fat. Workers, again, assist me during barreling, but then I seal the aging barrels myself, each and every one. The wine lies in the cellar, gains character. Once this process is complete, it becomes Saint-Réal. And as it happens, only I have the key to the cellar in question.
Who hauls the barrels to the palace?
We've our own garrison. Guards who have served here for years and would answer with their heads for the wine.
We'll not get anywhere asking questions, I see. It's a waste of time.
Your Grace, how am I to understand this?
Master Fabricio, we have proof someone's gained access to Saint-Réal. Someone who should not have, which means one of two things. Either you lie to our face, or you are an idiot who has had wine stolen from under his nose and not even realized it. In either case, you shall answer for it.
But...
Silence! And listen. I shall inspect the barrels in person, thus giving you time to reflect. When I return, I expect to hear answers. Remind me, where is the Saint-Réal stored?
In the main cellar, around the corner. I'll show you.
I shall find it. Give me the key to the cellar and wait here.
Of course, Your Grace. Here it is.
Come, Witcher.
We shall wait here, Master Fabricio.
What if Fabricio's blackmailing the vampire? Considered that?
He has his flaws, but I would never suspect him of such a thing. He's been very loyal. He owes all he has to me. His father frittered away the family fortune. He left his son an encyclopedic knowledge of wine. That is all. Fabricio lived as a beggar until I appointed him steward of Castel Ravello. Only then did he come into his own.
So where do we start?
Let us see if all the barrels are present. Here's the inventory ledger.
Vintner's log. Fermentation completed with no complications. Tapped above sediment line. Here it is, barreling. Everything lines up at first glance. Neatly and thoroughly documented.
Then we must follow our other lead. Benoit said the stain came from the 1269 vintage. Let's find it.
Got Pamino over here. Fiorano. Dandelion's favorite. Adores it.
Ah, yes. That sophisticated palette of his.
Est. Think everyone and their mothers heard of this wine.
Among the best in the world. Castel Ravello is famous for it.
Hervelus. I like it. Quite dry.
An excellent wine. You've good taste.
Sanreal. 1270 vintage.
That's the wrong year. Keep looking.
Sanreal. Barrels are dated 1268.
Close, but not quite the right year. Your eye. I've a feeling we'll find something awry.
Right here. 1269. What now?
Let's see if any barrels are empty.
Wanna open them?
For now, a knock will suffice. If you hear a hollow thud, we will have found what we seek.
Full.
Full?
Full. This one's full too. Full. This one's full too. Looks like all the barrels are full. Dead end, I'm afraid.
Full they are. The question is, are they full of San Real? Grab a tap and a hammer. We shall open them one by one and taste.
Ready. We can start. Ready.
Step aside.
So?
Those hints of spice. Distinctive. This is San Real. Revolting. Bitter plonk!
Could have gone sour while aging.
Impossible! This is not wine. This is contaminated refuse that should never have made it into a barrel. The fact that it did was no accident, I'm sure.
Master Fabricio, let's see what he has to say about it.
Master Fabricio, I am very disappointed.
But your grace, I...
You are a step away from losing your head. Speak the truth and you might yet keep it.
I admit it. I sold a barrel of San Real. I beg you to forgive me.
Why did you do it?
I couldn't resist. The sum they offered, it was enormous. I gave in.
Is what I provide not enough?
I wished to buy back my family's estate. For here, nothing is truly mine. I've a roof over my head, ample food to eat, but what is a nobleman without land of his own? I shall tell you everything, if you agree to show me mercy.
Really thought nobody'd find out.
I was a fool, very foolish. I beg you, Your Grace, you must forgive me.
Who'd you sell the wine to?
A few weeks past, at the pheasantry, a rich nobleman approached me. He called himself a diplomat, well-connected at court. He suggested we embark on an enterprise. Some of his clients had offered dizzying sums for even a drop of San Real. He was to serve as intermediary.
This man's name?
He never revealed it. He was tall, black-haired, and spoke with a foreign lilt. He claimed to hail from Sintra.
I've no Sintrian aristocrat at court.
Wine itself, how'd you hand it over?
We met under the cover of darkness in the ruins of Fort Astre. A dozen or so men came to collect. Armed men. The kind that stink of trouble. I had hauled the barrel there. They transferred it to their cart, and we went our separate ways.
That's it? At the last you ever saw of them?
That is to say, a few days passed. A messenger arrived. He said they wished to buy another barrel and, well, I've prepared it. Have it ready to deliver.
That's enough. Know all we need to know.
Your Grace, I beg your forgiveness.
Get out of my sight. Captain, have your men take Master Fabrizio to the dungeon. He must answer for his crime. High treason the charge. What now, Witcher?
We set a trap. Need to catch the wine thieves. Sentry and Noble could be our blackmailer. Next, transport. I'll take it to Fort Astra. Damien and his soldiers will cover me.
For once, I agree with you. We will do as you say. Let me know when you are ready.
See no reason to wait. Let's get going.
We will set out now. Position ourselves before you arrive. You take the cart and meet us there.
Fine. When the handoff begins, watch for my signal. Relax. Now we wait.
Ah, our favorite vintner.
Well, Richard.
just me, or did we agree you'd wait for my signal?
That was the plan, but...
Great shot. Good thing you reacted. Can't say how that would have ended otherwise.
At your service. It was a good fight. We managed to capture one of the scoundrels.
Let's ask him a few questions. Come on.
Witcher, a moment. I was wrong about you.
Well, had no reason to trust me, and I didn't do much to change that.
True. You are not the most endearing of men. At any rate, I see the effort you put forth. And I appreciate it. Let us go to Her Grace. She awaits nearby.
Wait, she here?
I hope you did not think I would leave this to you alone. Especially when every hour could prove essential. This prisoner of yours, bring him to me. We must ask him some questions. Captain, do the honors.
Who sent you?
His name is Dog. They say he plowed your mother.
Once again, who sent you?
Your nun's lover. They call it...
Wait. He doesn't wish to speak. He needn't. I can think of several other ways he can be helpful. I'm certain the Witcher will need bait to lure the beast of Beauclair.
What?
Sure can. Fresh out.
In that case, he's all yours.
Captain, have your men find me a strong rope. Kind that won't snap when we hang this fellow from a tree.
Rope?
Live bait. Great for monsters. Provided they catch the scent of its blood. But I'll see to that.
What? No. Crikey, no! Don't let him!
Stop screaming. Save your strength. Got a long night ahead of you.
No! Don't let him! I'll talk!
Barrels. Where were you gonna take them?
I don't know!
Captain, need that rope after all.
I truly don't know! Hornet's the leader, only he ever knew where to go. But he lies over there, dead. That one. The first barrel went to a warehouse at the port. But where this one was bound, I don't know. I speak true. You must believe me.
Who hired you?
He'll kill me.
Ought to be worried about me right now. Who is he?
Go on, man. Spit it out.
The Cintrian. That is what they call him. I've never seen him, but I know he mustered the men for this caper. That's what they said, that we were working for the Cintrian. I don't know anything else. I swear it.
Take him away. Throw him in the dungeon. He shall await trial there. Captain, we ride to town. Gather your men and seek out the Cintrian. Someone else must have seen him, must know of him.
Yes, Your Grace. I'll report to the palace as soon as I learn anything.
I shan't return to the palace. Our mission has not yet ended. The Witcher and I will await you at the guard post near the port.
Let's go to town.
It's late.
Relax, he'll come.
There's something I'd like to know. How can you be so damned calm?
Side effect of my mutations. We Witchers rarely get the jitters.
What if something has happened to him?
Captain seems like a man who can take care of himself.
Perhaps he can, but this Sintrian appears to be no common bandit. He managed to steal ducal wine from under my guardsman's gnosis. We only learned of it through a fortunate coincidence. And it was he who specified the victims for the vampire. One must be exceptionally confident to blackmail such a monster.
Sooner or later, everyone slips up. Sintrian stole the Sun Real. That was his mistake.
Yet if we had not happened on the wine stain...
You're right. We got lucky. Even so, still can't be sure he's behind the kidnapping, the blackmail. Need to find the Sintrian, whether or not he's responsible for the murders. Even if none of it's his doing, he could still know our blackmailer's identity. Besides, it's one thing to know who ordered the killings. Other thing entirely, and just as important, is why they... Someone's coming.
Captain, why so long? We expected you hours ago.
This Sintrian does not work alone. We are fighting an organization, not one man. Bandits attacked us, not a small force either. One of my boys has a broken arm, another a shattered knee, lamed for life. And the word on the street is there's a hefty bounty on your head, Geralt.
Don't care. Down to business. You learn anything?
I will start at the beginning. The port warehouse where the wine was delivered. We identified it, then learned who had hired it out. This proved to be a beggar, a stand-in. We found him. He admitted all. A man had paid him to sign the lease, a man he met while begging outside the pheasantry. There, fate lent us a hand. A waitress recalled spilling wine on a nobleman who spoke with a Sintrian accent.
What did he look like?
Her description was not helpful. Handsome, well-dressed, with a beard. No distinguishing marks. This could be anyone. But she remembered his female companion very well, as she recognized her. On the Sintrian's arm was Cecilia Bellant.
A singer? I've heard of her. She's said to be gifted, fairy.
The same. We went to her home immediately. Cecilia was not there, but we questioned her servants. A chambermaid claimed Cecilia is to meet a Sintrian gentleman tonight. She'd invited him to a reception mounted by the Mandragora.
The Mandragora? What's that?
A club. An affiliation of local artists. Painters, sculptors, troubadours and dancers.
Never heard of it.
They exude mystique. Consciously, I think. Behaving like an exclusive cabal. Artistic elites. Every now and again they mount soirees. Only wealthy patrons are invited. All arrive in elaborate masks, then drink and flirt.
Gotta nab the Sintrian. Seems we have to go to that get-together.
You read my mind, Witcher. I shall gather my men, surround the establishment. Not a mouse will squeeze through.
Out of the question. If the Sintrian truly does have men about the city, he will find out and escape once again.
Duchess is right. Need to be careful. Best go there, blend in with the crowd.
Precisely what we shall do.
We, Your Grace.
Geralt and I. In that sort of company, the Witcher could use my help.
Where's the event going to be held?
The Mandragora always assembles at the same place. A residence in Oatville. It's a very distinguished district. Geralt, you must don appropriate attire. Then meet me in Oatville, in Mountebank Alley.
Kiss a dog's ass.
One over on me, Witcher. I can see you're a kid.
Thank you.
Come on, Roach.
Slow now. Whoa.
The colors I would see on the Duchy's banners.
Patrolling on an empty stomach. Oof, dreadful.
Nothing to see here. Move along.
She looked at me, all right. Looked right.
That's me.
Sacre bleu. It's a crime. You're from the north, that's painfully clear.
Excuse me?
There is no excuse. There is but the need to outfit you anew. My salon stands open. Please come in.
All jests aside, let me see what you got in your wardrobe.
I'm more than willing, sir.
That's all I need for now.
Ever your servant, sir.
Quite the fragrant whiff. What is the pheasantry stewing up?
Nice tune.
It's a dog's ass.
Come on, Roach.
Kiss a dog's ass.
Late. Why does that not surprise me?
Such a sense of style. Not all bad. Nothing like a budding artist, of course, but... Just one other detail. Here, put it on.
A mask?
All who attend the Mandragora soiree wear them. If you have one on, no one asks who you are.
Any idea why they wear masks?
Likely because they imagine it oh so very romantic and mysterious. The truth is far simpler. This way, no one can tell which drunken aristocrats are pinching the performers.
Let's go. Soiree's started.
Mm-hmm. Wise of you to hide your weapons. They'd not have let us in otherwise, that's certain. How do we find this Cintrian? Have you a plan?
Key is not to spook him. Need to ask after his partner, Cecilia, first. Less likely to raise suspicions. As soon as we find her, we find him. Especially since he might be expecting us.
What do you mean?
Ran into some of his thugs in town. Knew who I was. Had it in for me.
Right. Right you are. We must proceed with caution. Come, it's our turn.
Madame, Monsieur, an extraordinary pleasure to welcome you to the Mandragora soiree. Tonight, I particularly recommend you direct your attention to the performances prepared by artists of our community.
Tell us about these performances.
This evening, the Mandragora has the honor to present three superb displays of artistry. The first was a concert by Cecilia Belont, a singer whose voice, were it stone, would surely be a diamond. Sadly, Mademoiselle Cecilia has sung.
Shame. You would have loved to hear her.
Luckily, you are in time to see the great Calesti, a master of visual illusions, come to us from far off afar.
Visual illusions. Interesting. And the third artist?
The third and fourth, for they are a duo, are the Tuven brothers, presenting their newest pantomime.
We were really hoping to meet Cecilia Belont.
You are admirers, I surmise. I'm certain you will have ample opportunity to converse with her.
It cannot be easy to identify anyone in this crowd. Perhaps you could help us find her.
I don't know where she is now, but I can give you a clue.
Let's hear it.
Seek the Kaviri Orchid.
Meaning?
Cecilia wears one in her hair. You shall recognize her easily by the orchid.
Well, well. Dandelion's always complaining about artists being poor as temple mice.
The residence belongs to none of them. They are guests here. Oriana, she owns this. Woman in the black dress, there on the balcony.
Got her. Doesn't wear a mask?
It would be pointless. All would know her anyway.
Kaviri Orchid, let's look for it. If we find Cecilia, we'll find the Cintrian.
Hey, tittle, tittle, the cat and the fiddle.
Please do not disturb. One false move, ruinous to the entire...
Go on, Geralt, be bold. Show us the artist in you. The paint balls, cast them at the canvas.
Toss a paint ball. Good folk, yet another soul longing to express its creative side.
Well, you and Mother Heart?
Sorry, too. It's not a landscape, you clever. It's a manifestation of the man's soul.
Blue blood is all ice.
Represents transgression in its purest form.
Should you tire of these hues, drop them in the pail and grab a different
solution. Requires quite precision.
Quite the noble. Spiritual dualism, the continual battle between good and evil, and defiance.
Oh yes, that's him all right. Good versus evil, the dualistic nature of man.
And defiance.
A true talent paints like the great art.
The great one.
He's a dance.
Sure to be in one of the alcoves.
The other one.
It must be something.
Absinthe, the preferred hooch of artists.
Careful, it packs a pretty powerful punch.
I've built up a pretty powerful resistance.
Beyond. beyond the bounds of cognition. Not heard the news?
I'm sure you understand. There are a great many highly qualified candidates.
Then I shall have to convince you, Your Ample.
We wish to be alone. Please, leave. We are busy.
It's an outrage. Be in one of the alcoves.
Cecilia never should have performed.
Look at the mage. I believe he's casting spells.
Yeah, we'll see.
My heart is about to burst from a surfeit of beauty.
Fine, let's give it a try.
How beautiful. Never suspected you believed. Look, lanterns. They say releasing them brings good luck. The dolphins. That is no ordinary illusion. The man is a true artist.
Impressive.
Cecilia never should have performed tonight. You should have.
It seems someone decided otherwise.
That someone knows nothing of true art. It shall be you next time. Trust me, I shall have a word with Oriana personally.
All sorts of criticism, but pretentious. So much time I spent polishing that one-man play.
and Countess de Saffel was there. That's the worst. Now she will never look me in the eye. It's an outrage. Cecilia never should have performed. You should have.
It seems.